いまから腕が鳴るわ。まったくだ。天下分け目の関ヶ原。いよいよ我らの剣が天下の役に立つ時が来たというもんだ。お若い先生、そんな真菊祭顔しとったら勝ち戦も負け戦になってまいますがな。さ、一献結構拙者、戦いの前に酒はやらん。
まさか下戸の先生がいるとは。<笑>おい、聞いたか、ここには酒も飲めねえ小僧がいるぜ。いや、下戸の若先生。おっと、これは失礼。まさか下戸の先生がいるとは。<笑>おい、聞いたか、ここには酒も飲めねえ小僧がいるぜ。いや、下戸の若先生。おっと、これは失礼。まさか下戸の先生がいるとは。<笑>おっと、これは失礼。まさか下戸の先生がいるとは。<笑>おお、どないしたんや。それともわしの酒が飲めへんちゅんか。それじゃ、いただこうか。おお、 素直やないか。さえ、それで、若いうちは強いやつの言うことを素直に聞くもんや。さあ、飲めや若いの。武蔵。
ああ、
宮本武蔵という。俺の名だ。
ああ、
若いのじゃねえ。
継がれた酒は飲めねえが、売られた喧嘩はいつでも買うぜ。おお、いいぞ。<笑>やれやれ。おお、ええ度胸しとるやないか若いの。<笑>わしは近江の一切りゴルハチこと真島ゴルハチ。よう覚えときや。
俺もあんたと同じで
人の名前を覚えられない太刀でな。<笑>まあええ。<笑>そないにでかい口叩くっちゅうことは剣の腕も相当なもんなんやろな。
さあ試してみるしかないだ。
せやな。ほな行くで若いの。
Alright, this is our first proper fight, proper boss battle, although we're still using Bokuto, so it's still non-lethal. Majima doesn't have nearly the strength that Marume does, but he is fast. He's the fastest enemy in the game. And any of you played the other Yakuza game should probably remember Majima. He's a constant in the series. He's always a little crazy and always likes to fight Kiryu, but he's also a good friend to him. The only difference in this game is he's now, instead of Majima Goro, he's Majima Goro Hachi. And yeah, his name just means 5, 6, 8 for some reason. A lot of our techniques will work if we can get behind him, which is, you know, 90% of the boss fighting in this game, is getting behind them. And we can use heat actions on him. That was actually disabled in the Marume fight. And now our heat gauge is full. I'm going to try to get one off here. There we go. This is the Bokuto heat action. You can only do it with wooden sword. You can't do any of the other sword attacks with a wooden sword, just that one. So yeah, his strong attacks break our block, but he can't really follow up on it, which is good for us. But still, you're never going to be able to hit him if you don't dodge him. If you're just blocking, you're not going to recover fast enough to hit him. We gotta level up.
まだまだ来るからもう勝負はついたこれが真剣勝負だったらお前は死んでる何やまだ人を斬ったこともないような若造が丸目さん
今からはしゃいでどうする? 力を使うにはまだ早いはずだ
よいではないか、丸目 喧嘩するだけの元気があって何よりじゃ
天海様
天海?
天海だと?
天海様だ
お主なかなか余裕でをしておるようじゃの大和殿控えろこのお方を誰と心得るかうん良い顔をしておるどちらの剣士様かのミマサカの国ほう作州の
して、そなたの流派は?ありません。冗談を。本当です。その者は宮本武蔵殿と申す無流派の剣士です。丸目。知行。
貴様どういうことだ浪人風情を舞台に入れるなどいや天海様宮本殿は無流派ですが腕の立つ男でしてどうだか分かっておるな今回の一件万が一にも失態は許さぬぞは承知しております
小次郎は?は?すでに目標の場所へそうかならばよい後のことは任せるはあしかしあの南工房天海まで出てくるとは
あんた、ほんまええ度胸しとるなさあそろそろ説明してくれてもええんやないですか丸目の旦那うん今回の作戦は徳川率いる東軍の裏切り者を斬ることにある東軍やと?
同じ徳川の軍の中に裏切り者がおるっちゅうことかおいどういうことだ裏切り者だと作戦は今夜決行まず裏切り者が宿を取っている屋敷に忍び込む人間を2名決める他の者はその2名の援護に回る2名つまり
その二人に選ばれた奴が大手柄を立てられるっちゅうことやなそうだだが死ぬ確率も最も高いさようどうだ志願する者はおらんか俺が行こう
本当にいいんだな?
ああ俺は中途半端に名声を得るためにここに来たわけじゃないもう後戻りはできないんだ
せやな兄ちゃんの言う通りやわしは大勢の人間を斬ってきた
こうなりゃあとは地獄か天国かしか待っとらせん。どうせやったら大手柄立てて天国へ行こうやないか。なあ。
よし。では決まりだな。
ああ。そうやな。
それでは二人に今回の作戦の詳細を伝える。残りの剣士たちは別までしばし待たれよ。
さあ話を聞こうやないか、丸目の旦那。
ああ、では今回の作戦の詳細について伝える。まず二人にはこの後すぐにこの場所を出て行ってもらう。
すぐに。
ああそうだ、深夜の寝込みを襲う。
奇襲作戦ってわけか。
そういうことだ。しかし寝込みといっても相手はかなりの人数を引き連れて屋敷に陣を張っている。よってまずお主たち以外の剣士が表から攻め込む。そして裏口からお主たちが忍び込み首を取る。
つまり他の剣士たちはおとりになるっちゅうことか。なるほどね。しかし丸目の旦那、備えに手の込んだ作戦つかなあかんちゅうことは、その裏切り者ってのは備えに偉いやつなんか。それに徳川家の参謀役である天海が仕掛け人なんやったら、こないにこそこそ行動する必要はないんてちゃうか。
天海様をもってしても表だって動けない敵ということだ。
それってあんた。
これ以上は聞かない方がよい。知らない方がお前たちのためだ。
丸目さん、
どうした。
この作戦、もしも俺たちがそいつの首を取ったらどうすればいい。
とりあえず屋敷から逃げ出すんだ。屋敷の裏口から逃げ、南に三里ほど行った参道に古い寺がある。そこに集まれ。
その場所にたどり着けば作戦は成功ということか。
ああ、寺の中に入り迎えの者を待て。
分かった。
話は以上だ。あとはお前たちにかかっている。
ああ、
ほな作戦の成功を祈って。
ああ
、
宮本武蔵、真島五郎八、お主たちは本当に良い目をした剣士だ。今回の作戦、私はお主たちに声をかけてしまったことを少し悔いている。
おいおい、誘っておいてそれないんとちゃうか、丸目の旦那。
その通りだ。それとも何か、まさか戦う前から俺たちが死ぬと思ってんのか。
いや、そうではないのだが。ではそろそろ出発の時間だ。生きろ。
え？
死んでしまったら全ては終わりだ。本当に後がなくなった時は逃げろ。何がおかしい？
急に何言ってるんだ、マルメさん。
は？ほんまやで。死ぬ気でやれやの、生きろやの、逃げろやの。あんた言ってることがめちゃくちゃやで。
本当だな。少し酒が回ってしまったのかもしれん。では。
騒がしくなったようやな。わしらもぼちぼち始めようか。
ああ、
とっとと肩をつけて丸目のおっさんにええ酒でもごちそうしてもらいまひょが。
そうだな。
ほな、行くで。
何者だ。
でもしたんか。
いや大丈夫だ。
よし、ほな行こう。
何してるんや。早よ行くで。
ああ。
Alright, so we are here in our first action stage. That is a story-based continuous battle. We're in the combat zone for the entirety of it as we go through the house, and there will be a lot of samurai fights. Basically, in story-based missions, you can assume we are killing them, but in random encounters and stuff, somehow they usually survive. The basic difference between extreme and other difficulties is, for story-based missions, there is the same number of enemies, but they are more aggressive, they block a lot more, and in general, enemies do more damage. They do about double the damage to you, and you do half the damage to them you normally would. Also, the heat gauge tends to drain faster when you're not attacking and not building it up. I think that's pretty much it. Now, I mentioned that you don't get abilities from fighting, so we actually have a very small repertoire of moves, and only two heat actions we can do with the sword right now. We're allowed to switch to hand-to-hand, and we're allowed to switch to our kodachi, our short sword, anytime. We don't have any actions we can do with that right now, so there's really no advantage to it. So we're going to be using the Ito, the single sword style, for the duration of this action stage. Now you can tell I'm already taking damage, and fortunately Majima's distracting a lot of them, and he's invincible, so they're not just ganging up on us. But this can get hairy, and this is not going to be an item free run. I might do that if I was playing with a built up level 50 character, that's the max level, but I don't think that's going to be possible. So, you will sometimes see me using inventory stuff to heal. Now, the picture of our sword in the top left, that, the swords do actually look different, although just slightly, and the name of it is displayed there. It's called the Sakshu no Tachi. And Sakshu is just another name from Minasaka Province, where Musashi's from. So it's his hometown sword. Even on a New Game Plus, you start with that sword. It's not very strong. In fact, we'll actually be able to find another weapon here. And most weapons are not found, they're forged, but once in a while you can find them. And not too many of them are unique, either. Another difference on the extreme mode is there are no continues. So normally you could just start the action stage over, but on extreme you have to go back to your last save. We got another level up. As I mentioned, you don't gain abilities, you gain health bar, you gain heat gauge, you also gain a little attack power and defensive power, innate defensive power. We get a little bonus from the armor too. That is the only standing heat action that's available from the start of the game with the sword. You can slice them through one of these curtains. The other thing you can do is finish him off on the ground. That you can always do. You don't have to learn that move. It's a good idea if you're trying to complete all the heat actions to make sure to do that move in here, because there's actually not that many fights that take place inside the Tommy rooms and stuff in the game, which is the only place you'll be able to do that. So, it's just you might want to make sure to get it out of the way, kind of. Now these are just kind of generic mooks, so we can actually break through their guard by using our power slide attack, or our Zanchin. It will not work on bosses and stuff. You do get what is essentially invincibility. Yeah, here I'm going to use some health. You do essentially get invincibility frames when you dodge, so you might have seen this before. I actually dodged like right through his sword, but it still didn't hit me. In a lot of ways, the unarmed guys, which is one we just finished off there, he's more dangerous than regular ones because he can still just grab you by the collar, and then the other guys can just run up and stab you in the back. And some of them later on in the game will be really brutal, where they just grab you even while you're trying to stab them. They reverse you. We're going to want to pick up some of the items these guys have. We may need health later on. So yeah, there's a very limited repertoire of moves I'm able to break out here. You may notice we're gaining levels pretty fast. That won't continue to be the case, but since we started level 1, there's 50 levels in the game, that's the max level, and we will probably get to 50 like just before the end of the game. There, picked up a new weapon. That is the Nameless Tachi, or Nameless Katana, you know, depending. But I won't use it right now. It's only slightly better than the one we've got, and it doesn't really look any different in battle. It's just time for a little break, I guess. We're out of combat mode for the time being, but our heat gauge is still draining as we're not attacking. This gives you a chance to switch up your weapons and use any items you want, but you could do that during the fight too. I mean, it doesn't prevent you from doing that. You saw me use a healing item. Alright, we don't have Majima to back us up anymore, so we're on our own from here on out. That's the sword finishing move, or single sword finishing move, the only other heat action we can do with it right now. We're still free to use unarmed style, but they break the guard pretty well on higher difficulties. But I will be using unarmed against swordsmen in the future. Yep, there are QTEs in the game. Now this guy is, simply put, a better swordsman than the others. He's a kind of boss. He has more life, he takes less damage, and yeah, he does that move. In the future, just generic enemies are going to be doing it, but it's pretty brutal. It breaks your guard, or it pushes you back, and it knocks you down until you've leveled up a bit and gained some extra like abilities to help you stay on your feet. He also he kind of pushes you back when your attack is blocked by him. So there's one way to get through those attacks. That is, they wait for you to put your guard down, so you just quickly let go of the guard button and then put it back up, and you can block it. And then that's your chance to strike him, because he's open for just a brief second. But basically what we're going to have to do here is get behind him. And that's going to be the main strategy for most difficult enemies in the game. A lot of enemies recover and recover from being stunned faster than Musashi does. Not as hard as Marume, though. You also lose heat gauge when you get hit by the enemy, so unless you're basically just hitting him over and over and not taking damage, and you're not just standing around guarding very much, it's really hard to keep your heat gauge up. That's not so much true on, say, normal, where your heat gauge takes a lot less time to go down and doesn't lose as much from being hit. These early fights, these early boss battles, are really just wars of attrition, because you don't have a move set that can do very much, and they're less interesting, which also makes some of these early battles maybe the hardest in the game. Because later on you have a lot of stuff you can do, a lot of tricks you can do. And we'll be learning new abilities all the way up into the final chapter of the game. It's really one of my only complaints about the game. That's fine with me if you don't gain all the abilities even up till the end, but I would have liked to have at least some way to carry them over into a new game plus. That amulet that I got from the letter when we first started the prologue, that'll let you do all the heat actions in the game right from off the bat, but it still won't teach you the non-heat techniques. There's just no way to start with those. And those are actually more important. Again, on the higher difficulties, heat actions actually don't do that much damage. They're more for show, and they're flashy, and they're fun, but they don't just destroy enemies like they do on maybe normal. So your non-heat, regular techniques that you can do are far more important. We're getting in the danger zone here, but if we can beat this guy, we're going to be all done.
やったんか。ああ。無念。弟を、あの天界から救い出してやれなかったことか。天界から弟を救い出す。
どうした?
これはどうや?
ういうことや。この門は徳川の。裏切り門ちゅうのは徳川本家の人間やったんか。貴様らこちらのお方が徳川家の嫡男結城秀康様と知ってんの狼藉か。待て、逃がすな、おえ。